UN 영어놀이. Why does Canada have three of the world's most livable cities? 위드 밴쿠버, 캘거리 앤드 토론토 all ranked in the top 10 of the global livability index 2023. We speak to residents in each city to find out what makes life so sweet. While European and Scandinavian destinations frequently find themselves atop world indexes, like the world's healthiest countries or best countries for raising children, Canada has quietly been marching up the ranks as a country to contend with. That's been especially apparent in the latest Most Livable Cities Index, conducted by the Economist Intelligence Unit, which named three of Canada's cities in the top 10, more than any other country represented. The top three Canadian cities on the list included Vancouver, ranked 5th, Calgary, tied 7th with Geneva, and Toronto, ranked 9th, each with perfect healthcare and education scores. Those factors appeal to Canadians who praise positive governmental policies that improve quality of life there. Our progressive politics and universal health care make Canada a wonderful place to live, said Vancouver resident Samantha Falk. I cannot imagine living in a country where I have to worry about being able to afford to see a doctor, or take my child to the hospital, or risk bankruptcy by having cancer. This sense of care extends beyond politicians, leading to a feeling of community that improves livability, both at work and home. Lending a hand at schools, to supporting seniors, to uplifting business owners, Canadians are known for their friendly and supportive nature, said Jane Stoller, Vancouver resident and founder of Organized Jane, a life business organizing service. This sense of camaraderie fosters a positive environment where individuals can thrive and find fulfillment in both their personal and professional lives. Canadians love the strong connection that the nation has to the outdoors. Canada's investment in public transportation and transit systems also makes navigating its big cities easier. Falk, who has also lived in Montreal, Calgary, and Toronto, didn't get her driver's license until she was 24, and a friend of hers is finally getting his at 53, simply because they haven't needed a car to get around. However, what residents love most is the strong connection that the nation has to the outdoors. All three of the most livable cities, like so many cities in Canada, are located close to nature. and have also incorporated it into their city design, said Falk. There's the Lavin system and the beaches in Toronto, Mount Royal and three-lined streets in Montreal, and Vancouver has Stanley Park, one of the world's best examples of urban nature. But even outside the big cities, the focus on nature remains a prominent feature, mirroring the importance of the wilderness to residents. We are outdoor people, Falk said. Spread across the world's second largest country by landmass, each of the three Canadian cities has their own unique appeal. We talk to residents in each place to find out what keeps them living in and loving their respective cities. Vancouver's Stanley Park is a green oasis and one of the greatest urban parks in the world. Vancouver, located on the country's scenic west coast, Vancouver inched up as Canada's most livable city thanks to sky-high scores in the Culture and Environment Sub-Index, outranked only by Auckland in the top 10. That's a sentiment the residents echo, who are blown away by the natural beauty here. Vancouver's unique and gorgeous combination of mountains and ocean makes it irresistible, said Falk, who runs her eponymous communications firm out of the city. Even after 20 years living in Vancouver, the city still takes my breath away. To get the most out of the city and feel at home here, she says you must get outside, even and especially when it's raining. One easy place to do that is Stanley Park, a 405-hectare public park in the city center, that has a coastal rainforest with centuries-old trees, including the still-standing stump of a 700 to 800-year-old red cedar called the Hollow Tree. For the truly hardcore, she recommends hiking the 2.5-kilometer Gros Grind Trail up at the face of Gros Mountain, often referred to as nature's stairmaster. The trail will make you feel like throwing up, but the payoff at the top is well worth it, she said. Have a coffee or a glass of wine at the mountaintop restaurant and soak in the view, and take the gondola down. For those that prefer calm adventures, the food scene is one that's hard to beat. From fancy restaurants to cool food trucks and farmers markets, you will never run out of tasty treats, said Stoller. Residents especially rave about Vancouver's sushi, which she says is the best and the cheapest selection of sushi restaurants outside Japan. The city also fosters an entrepreneur and collaborative mindset that creates a welcoming sense of home. Vancouver people are open-minded, diverse, and love coming together for arts, tech, or green initiatives, said Storer. She also says the small geographical footprint keeps the city organized and creative. You won't find as many big box stores here, which promotes shopping local and supporting the community, she said. It's a win-win for everyone. Residents describe Calgary as having a small town feel with the big city amenities. Calgary, situated near the Rocky Mountains in the western province of Alberta, Calgary outscored the other two Canadian cities with its perfect stability, result in the index, a measure of civil unrest and government corruption. Residents describe Calgary as having a small town feel with big city amenities, while also having a lower cost of living than Canada's other comparable cities. Despite being one of the largest cities in Canada, Calgary manages to retain a unique charm, one that comes from friendly locals, a community-oriented mindset, and the neighborhood-centric farmers markets, said resident and the travel blogger Laura Pope. Yet it doesn't lack when it comes to trendy eateries, cultural festivals, and amazing nightlife. The city is also diverse, the third most diverse in Canada, with more than 240 ethnic origins and 165 languages. The city also has a lucrative oil and gas industry, a large white-collar business community, and an affordable cost of living. Calgarians have money and love to spend it, said JCP Kayabo, a communications professional who moved to the city from Edmonton 3 years ago. That means the walkable downtown and the surrounding areas are packed during the summer months, while hockey season sees suits and ties swapped for Calgary Flames jerseys, she explained. The annual Calgary Stampede, which starts the first Friday of July, serves as a 10-day party and rodeo, where everyone wears Western gear and the festival welcomes people from all over the world. People go out, patios are packed, and restaurants are busy, echoed resident Shannon Hughes, owner of Calgary-based Captivate Benefits Advisory Firm. She suggests booking a spot at Major Tom Restaurant at sunset to truly appreciate the city's mountain views. Like much of Canada, the ease of access to nature improves the quality of life here. Calgary has the most extensive paved pathway and bikeway network in North America, with more than 1,000 kilometers of paths for walkers and cyclists. My bike rides along these paths have led me to discover some of the city's hidden gems, provided spectacular views, and given me a daily dose of the outdoors that I crave, said Pope. Even in winter, the city has no shortage of activities, from skiing, skating, tubing, snowshoeing, and even ice biking, with much of the infrastructure still in place. from when the city hosted the 1988 Winter Olympics. Residents to say the winters are long and cold, so expats coming from warmer climates should invest in some good quality winter gear. Toronto's PATH network connects more than 30 kilometers of restaurants, shopping, services, and entertainment. Toronto, as Canada's most populous city, Toronto combines big city vibes with more than 1,500 parks that keep residents connected to the outdoors. With a perfect score in the stability of ranking, Toronto maintains a sense of safety that lets people feel comfortable whether they are walking, taking public transport, or cycling. In particular, the human-centered infrastructure means that life is much easier than in comparable big cities. Residents especially rave about the PATH, the underground pedestrian walkway that makes the Canadian winter more bearable. From my office to the airport, train, dining, shopping, and even doctor appointments, everything is conveniently accessible without the need for a winter coat, said resident Huang Anne, who blogs at Luxury on the Budget. Resident Kyla Maskell agrees, saying, while the Toronto Transit Commission, TTC, isn't without its flaws, having integrated transit options, most of which come within 4 minutes, makes a world of difference when coming from a suburb where driving is the only option. We also have rental bikes all around the city, which is a great green-friendly commuting option I've recently enjoyed, she added. The city is also known for its diversity, with more than 51% of its residents born outside of Canada. It's the only major Western city where the visible non-white minority is the majority, said Marcus Rader, CEO and co-founder at software company HostAway. There are chances to experience a lot of cultures and languages here, and Canada embraces multiculturality rather than pushing for assimilation. This cultural diversity enriches the community through a variety of festivals, cuisines, and every price point, and a respect for sharing new ideas and ways of living. An entrepreneurial spirit also influences Toronto. From big business, Uber, Google, and Facebook all have offices here, to new startups. In recent years, the city has become North America's third largest tech hub, just behind New York City and Silicon Valley. When paired with the city's diverse community, the tech scene creates great exposure to people from different cultures and backgrounds, say residents. It's interesting getting to learn cultural habits in relation to people's work and personal lives, said Jonathan Ajori, CEO and co-founder of Catch Corner, an app to book sports facilities. It's almost as if you gain a sense of international work-life experience without needing to leave the city.